I'm trying to learn to be a vegetarian now as something that's both personal and political. But it's not easy because my entire life has been based on eating meat under several illusions. One illusion is that if you eat meat, you're somehow getting a balanced diet because the food industries in America all got together in the 1950s and they were competing with each other. And they said, okay, this is not going to work. Let's tell Americans that they should eat everything in every meal. So they created this idea of the food groups that then they can split up the market in a way that would benefit all of them. So they convince Americans that every meal they should have grain and vegetable and fruit and meat especially and milk. Instead of eating seasonally or eating what's available when it's available, they created this myth and they endorsed it with doctors and the whole institutional structure was brought to bear on this idea that's an illusion. So, you know, I'm trying to break out of that illusion.
My interest in working with craftspeople began with my own questioning of my own notions of what is knowledge. Even more closer, what is sense of beauty? Because through our educational system, what we are doing is a colonization process, that even our sense of beauty get conditioned. And then I wonder how can we claim that we belong to this culture? So to me, the process of working with craftsmen was mainly to recover my own sensibilities, my authentic sensibility, senses. In that process, I realized that, by the forces of modernity, this whole destruction of indigenous wisdom.
Yeah, I think that.
Yeah. And I found that the fundamental issue is, these two are completely different cultures. Meaning, the modern educated indigenous do not belong to the culture in which the indigenous or the traditional craftsmen belong. Because the whole worldviews are different. And this is also, and I also found that the fundamental tool used for knowledge itself is different. Meaning the traditional people use intuition as a way of knowing.
We tend to believe that only those who are taught something, for example, those who go to film schools or those who go to art schools can draw, or those who go to film schools can produce films or produce television shows. So then we tend that we are not capable, we are not. I think there is some amount of ridicule by the dominant system on us that makes us not believe in our own selves, that we can be producers too. And what's the harm in trying, experimenting, failing, falling down and getting up again and saying, okay, but this was my expression. For me, learning society is that possibility where these multiple producers exist against a society which is dominated by a system where few produce for others to consume.
क्या अचीव करना है अचीवमेंट का इंडिकेटर कहीं आप बोल रहे हैं कि इंडिकेटर रखनी नहीं चाहिए
ये एंटीसिपेशन वाली बात हो जाती है अब मुझे नहीं मालूम कि क्या क्या शेयरिंग होगी तो मैं पहले से कैसे एंटीसिपेट कर सकता हूँ तो गोल इन द सेंस एक जो हमारा जो पाथ है वहां पे अगर इफ वी आर ऑनेस्ट विद द प्रोसेस तो आई डोंट थिंक वी कैन एंटीसिपेट द एंड और अगर हमने एंटीसिपेट कर लिया तो फिर हम उसको एक दिशा देने की वो शुरुआत कर रहे हैं. हमें ये मालूम है कि हम कुछ चीज़ें जानते हैं एजुकेशन सिस्टम के बारे में, लर्निंग के बारे में, सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट के बारे में. कुछ हमारे पास एक इमेजेस हैं और हमारे हमें जो प्रेजेंट कंडीशन के जो खतरे हैं वो हमारे हमें हम कुछ अवेयर हैं उससे. लेकिन एब्सोल्यूट हम कि यही और वो उस चक्कर में पड़ेंगे तो बहुत मुश्किल है.
करीबन एक साल पहले स्कूल छोड़ दिया है तो मेरे सामने ये बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है कि अब स्कूल तो छोड़ दिया है, मेरे घर वाले, मेरे जो रिश्तेदार हैं सारे मुझ पर इतना प्रेशर जो डाल रहे हैं तो उनके सामने मैं क्या जवाब रखूं? वो कह रहे हैं कि अगर तुम स्कूल नहीं जाना चाहते तो क्या, तो वो मीडिया कैसे तलाश करूँ कि मैं स्कूल के अलावा कौन कौन से मीडिया हैं सीखने के. तो बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है मेरे सामने.
What does it actually mean to find a new path, a path that's really doesn't have a plan, doesn't have like a map to it, where you can't basically say to someone, yes, I know I'll be successful in 10 or 15 years, or in 20 years I'll have a lot of money, or things will be fine in 10 years. And we're not used to living with that kind of uncertainty. So how do you deal with that uncertainty? Dealing with that uncertainty is also a part of learning. And we're not used to the notion of learning being messy and the notion of learning being unplanned. We want to fit all our learning into very clear planned boxes, and it just doesn't work, especially in our times.
Learning, as per my consideration, is where living is. Living means all kinds of activities that are related to our practical life. Practical situation, practical concerns, our day-to-day struggles, etc.
For learning society, I think anything which we have to unlearn or learn, we have to have this a space where there is that living example. Oh, you know, like I mean, for instance, when you go into the forest, there is life there which helps you to unlearn. You know, then you begin to feel that you are very small. You know, nature is more powerful, and then you begin to learn from plants, then small creatures, animals, but they are living.
और मैंने देखा है कि जो लोग स्कूल में नहीं सीखे, कॉलेज में नहीं सीखे, उनसे ही मैं ज्यादा से ज्यादा सीखा हूँ. जैसे कहीं जाता हूँ तो कोई बकरी, कहीं दूर दराज के आदिवासी एरिया में, तो बकरी के बाल से वो अपना जो पलंग होता है, जो अपना जिसको बोलते हैं उसकी गद्दी बनाता है. कभी मैं जाता हूँ कुछ खेत में तो एकदम अनपढ़ किसान है तो वो कोई पेड़ का उपयोग करके ही रासायनिक खाद के अल्टरनेटिव में उसको यूज करता है. तो ये जो लोग नहीं पढ़े हैं, नहीं कॉलेज में सीखे हैं, वो मुझे काफी सिखाते हैं और मुझे काफी आनंद आता है उसमें.